Hi guys, welcome back to the channel again. It's me on my own. I just thought I would come on the channel and just have a little chat with you about a few things that are going on or that have happened. And in the comments, if you can put your views, put any questions you want, and I might try and make this like a regular thing. But the first thing on my mind to talk about is Blackpool opening weekend, because as I'm sure you've seen from my vlog and loads of posts online, it did not go to plan. And I just thought, where did Blackpool go wrong? And that's not to slate the park or the management or the engineering. Like, they all tried their best, I'm sure, to get rides up and running. Like, it's just a shame that things didn't work out for them, and it hasn't put me off wanting to go back, as obviously we are all going back later on in the season. I think a big problem last weekend was the lack of communication from the park to the guests. It was shocking, really. Fair enough, we knew about a week, 2 weeks in advance that Grand Prix is SB&O, it's going, and Ice Blast was shot. Like, we all knew that. And obviously everyone goes to Blackpool for the big one. Like, that is a huge part of people's visits to Pleasure Beach. So with our group having some like first timers, obviously we knew that weather might mean big one wouldn't run, and we're fine with that. And it's obviously gone through a retrack in the off season, so we were like, oh, okay, maybe it won't. Then it was mentioned that it had test run, and we were like, okay, that's a really good sign. And then we kept checking the website every day, and there was nothing to say that it was planned maintenance for it to be shut. And so we thought, fantastic. Night before, we're checking it, still saying it's fine, and we're like, absolutely brilliant, like, wonderful. The morning of the park reopening, it suddenly appeared on that list with no word of warning. So I just don't know how it could have been planned maintenance when it happened that morning. Like, if they knew it was going to be shut, which I think potentially they knew that it wasn't going to open, they should have communicated that way before the morning of the park opening, because people could have travelled, like us, from loads of different places, thought, oh, okay, the weather's looking fine for it to run, it's not on the website, so it must be open. And then to find that out on the morning, it was a little bit sore. But yeah, like I said, nothing against the engineering team. Like, at the park on the day, ride reliability was shocking. Like, Revolution broke loads. Obviously, Infusion was having problems. Avalanche had problems. Like, everything had its teething problems, which you expect when a park reopens. And I cannot fault the engineering, because they must have been so fed up by the end of the day. They must have evacuated Revolution about 6 times. And they still kept going back, still kept trying to get it up and running again. So, like, I cannot fault the engineering team. I just think the social media team should have communicated things better with the guests, or the park itself should have communicated better. But we're going to draw a line under that. And we're looking forward to going back and giving the park another chance later on in the season. Especially for those of us that had never been before. It'll be really nice for them to go back. We're going to go on a late night riding weekend, so we have more time to do everything. And yeah, hopefully they'll come away from the park this time feeling a little bit more positive. We did make the best of a bad situation as well, though, which is obviously good. It's the best thing you can do in those sort of situations. Like, you could just sit around and mope all day about things going wrong, say to yourself, look, we're here, we've made the trip, we've paid, let's just enjoy ourselves as best we can, which is what we did, and we ended up having a really, really nice day. The next thing to talk about is obviously next weekend, Alton Towers reopens, which I'm really excited for. Since Bianca has started working there, the park has come into a new lease of life. She is the best thing to happen to that resort, in my opinion. Everything seems to be on like an upward trajectory now for the park, which is lovely to see. As Alton Towers has always felt very magical, but in recent years, some of that magic has slipped away, but it feels like it's coming back now. There's so much to talk about with Alton Towers reopening. So I'll do the first big obvious one. Nemesis is back. Nemesis Reborn is opening. I can't wait to get back on. Can't wait to see what it's like. I know there's a new queue route. A lot of us are speculating as to whether we're going to have a pre-show. So it'll be really exciting to go in and experience it as a new experience and see what I think of it now. As I've always liked Nemesis, but it's not been my favourite. But the retrack might change that. Like, old Nemi and Nemesis Inferno, I would take Inferno. Now with the retrack, I don't know. I'll have to get back on both the Nemesises to decide and see how the retrack has made a difference. Another great thing for opening weekend this year is, of course, it's open until 8 p.m. It's like Alton After Dark, I think it's called, which again means more time to explore the park, get back on everything, and also get rides in the dark earlier on in the season, which is something I love. One of my favourite things about Scarefest is rides in the dark. But with Scarefest, you have the mixture of wanting to do the scare mazes as well. So sometimes it doesn't work out that you can make the most of that time to ride in the dark alongside doing mazes. So it's nice to have that opportunity earlier on in the season now to just make the most of a later evening at the park. It's going to be really fun. A good group of us are going again, so we're just going to have a really good day, and I'm feeling very, very positive about it. More big news, of course, we now have a new tallest roller coaster in the UK. Hyperia is fully complete, all the track is up. It's a huge moment for UK enthusiasts. I don't think I will see this happen again in my lifetime in our country, so it's a big thing for UK enthusiasts. Big One has done us proud for 30 years, but now is Hyperia's time. And someone was saying to me the other day, I don't seem that excited for it, but I don't drive, I can't easily get to Monk's Walk during closed season, so I feel very out of it. Obviously I've not been like other people, like Jack Silkstone or Dominic Gardner, who are constantly there updating, and those updates have been incredible, so like a big well done to those guys for getting the updates out. But I think my excitement will kick in when I see it in person, as I'm sure it was the same for everyone else who has been to Monk's Walk while it's been constructed. So I think when I go in there for my first visit of the season and see it, that's when I will start to get the buzz. Like, I'm excited for it anyway, but I just think seeing that structure there now compared to what it was at the end of the 2023 season, that is what's going to really get me excited for it to open so we can get on it. I cannot wait. And it's looking to be one of the best roller coasters in Europe, potentially. It looks good. That first drop is going to be insane. And yeah, I just can't wait to get on there. I'm excited to get back to Chezzy, of course, that's coming up. They've not really got a big investment this year, but I just adore the park, so it'll be really, really nice to get back and get on some of my old favourites that I've grown up with. Obviously, Legoland have got a new coaster coming, that's really exciting. Adventure Island has a new drop tower opening at some point, that's really exciting. Drayton has now announced that Shockwave is now called The Wave. It's now a sit-down coaster. It's not a 1.4 anymore. It's now a 1.2. That's exciting. And of course, they have their brand new themed area and a brand new coaster. So this year really is the year for the UK parks to shine, I think. And I have no doubt. I have so much faith in our parks that this year is going to be one of the best seasons in a long, long time. Going overseas, obviously, Voltron has been testing Europa Park, but I don't think we're going to get it on our trip, which is really sad and really disappointing. I was hoping it would be ready to go, but it looks like we might just miss out on it. But it's another excuse to go back. And that, again, looks like one of the best roller coasters in Europe. It looks so good. The theming looks amazing. Like, we've never been to Europa Park anyway, so we're just excited to do everything that was already there. And if Voltron does open, it's a bonus. If it doesn't, it's fine. We'll definitely plan a trip to go back and get back on it. I'm trying to think, what else can we talk about? Oh yeah, we're going back to Plopsaland soon, which is really exciting. Obviously, we went for our first visit last year and absolutely fell in love with the place. Ride to Happiness is insanely good. And there's a new dark ride there. I think it's called like Bumba's World Tour, which we saw being constructed, but obviously we never got on it. So a new ride to do at the park, and I'm looking forward to that. Of course, we're going back to Plops Aqua, which I'm really, really excited for. like, that water park has a really special place in my heart. It was so fun last year. It's only small, but like, you can spend a good few hours and do everything multiple times and just have a really nice chilled evening after a day at the park or after a day traveling. It's really exciting. Then, on the subject of water parks, I think we're going to aim to do more of them. Obviously, we said previously we're going to go to Splashdown Pool. I went there in the summer of 2014 and loved it, and Ewan's never been. I would love to go back, so I think we're aiming to do that in like the spring sort of months, so either like April or May we're going to go. Although May is looking quite busy now, so maybe April, maybe June. And then another water park we're wanting to go to is Stoke Waterworld. I think Ewan's been quite a while ago. I've never been, but now we're getting into our water parks. That's somewhere we want to go to. Also, I'm really sorry if the angles change. My camera went a bit weird after I filmed the last section about Splashdown, so I had to like move it a bit. So sorry if the angle has slightly changed. I'm just excited for this year now. Like, I'm just going to live my best life. I'm going to stay as positive as I can, because I've been struggling with a lot of things recently. I've been going through a lot of grief. I'm not going to go into too much detail about it yet, as I'm still not ready to talk about it. But I'm in the long process of grieving someone, and I have my good days, I have my bad days, and I have my really, really awful days. And a few weeks back I was in a very dark place with my grief, and I just don't want to go back to that place again, because I know that person wouldn't want me to be like that. So I'm just trying my best to stay positive, keep myself busy. I've got great friends, great family around to support me through it as well, which really helps. But yeah, I'm finally seeing the light now. And I'm finding it a little bit easier to be positive. As in a way, I feel guilty to be happy. But equally, I know that person would want me to be happy. So we're just going to move and we're going to go with it. And it's okay to have a few bad days. Everyone knows around me that I'm not going to be 100% all the time, and I myself need to accept that, and I am starting to. So I think that's just the main reason. Like, I'm just so ready to take this year now and smash it out of the park. I love doing YouTube, so I'm going to keep uploading as much as I can, hopefully more regularly than I have done in previous years. Like I said, I'm going to start doing just videos like this midweek when I'm not with Ewan, but the main bulk of vlogs and trips will be with him, which is mainly what he's here for. We're going to do a couple of sit down videos together at some point, but like, a lot of sit down stuff will just be me on my own. But yeah, 2024 is really shaping up to be a cracking year, and I can't wait for the rest of what March holds. We've got the parks opening, like I said, Blackpool's ticks off, and the next one is Towers. So yeah, the next video you see on the channel will be the zoo day video. I'm going with Ashley, just to have a few hours out the house, see if we can film any updates of how Chezzy are preparing for their season, but mainly just to capture some of the animals on camera and just have a chat in one of my favorite places. Anyway, I think that's it for now. I feel like I've rambled on quite a bit. If you've enjoyed this, please do like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. Leave in the comments any video requests you have for us, and I will see what we can do. Any videos you think I could do solo that you'd like to see, let me know. And yeah, I look forward to seeing you all in another video. So I will say bye for now.